Are you ready?
Hey peeps, how's it going? Hopefully you guys are still staying safe out there. Hopefully you guys are doing well. And I look forward to talking to you guys this week. You know, tonight we got the last round table before the NFL draft. You're getting DSA's mock draft. It's going to be fun. It's going to be on Luke G's channel tonight, so go over there and subscribe to that. And then Thursday, Luke is also hosting round one of the draft. And then Friday, I am hosting round two. So you're going to want to subscribe to everybody. Everyone's producing stuff. And then I know Jim's got round three and four, a.k.a. Lions on a Prowl. And outside of that, I still don't know. But let's talk some basketball, man. And I was going to put the picture of Blake with the shirt off, but then I started to think about your health. You guys already get to see me. If you start throwing people with their shirts, there's going to be too much sex appeal. YouTube's going to demonetize it. It might be considered an X video. So I want to play it safe. You know, I think my face is sexy enough. We don't have to show it for your safety and for mine. The jokes aside, this is awesome. You know, Blake is in LA right now. Sekou went to France, by the way, and reportedly the Pistons don't know about it. I could talk about that too, I guess, if there's no topics later. But he's in LA, he's working out, he's rehabbing still, and you love to see it. You love to see it, because I know Blake's super disappointed with the way the season went this year, and even though technically it may not be over, it may be over, we still kind of don't know. We'll find out here in a week or two, maybe. He was disappointed, man. He wanted to be there because if Blake was healthy, this team's still a playoff team. That's the thing that, you know, is so hard to kind of wrap our heads around because they look terrible. We just didn't have Blake Griffin. Blake was our best player. You know, we relied way too much on Derrick Rose than what we needed to. Derrick Rose balled out this season, but our whole plan was to have Blake healthy, and, you know, we had the emergence of Christian Wood. I don't really think the Pistons expected that. It's been up and down, but I know Blake individually. I can tell you, because as a player who's played sports, and, you know, he doesn't have to be basketball, it could be anything. When you're not there to help your team and they're losing, it's terrible. Even when you're there and they're losing, you're terrible, because you always kind of blame yourself. You have to. As a leader, that's what you have to do. So I'm sure Blake feels responsible, or at least a huge part, him mentally, for this team not doing well this year. So I think that Blake's coming back, and he's going to come back extremely, extremely good next year. I think that we'll get maybe not as good as last year's Blake Griffin, but if not, damn close to that Blake Griffin. I think he's just going to be hungry. You know, he's going to be fighting for a contract here. I think after next year, he's got player options. So next year might be potentially Blake's last year, unless he opts in or out. We'll have to wait and see. But that means the next 2 years, Blake's going to be balling out. I cannot wait for this guy to get back on the court, man. The Pistons need him. The fans want to see him. You know, people love Blake, and it's just good for both parties, man. I'm rooting for Blake to come back, because there's a lot of people out there who don't like Blake Griffin, who don't want to see him come back, and I'm just the opposite. Healthy Blake, we're a playoff team, and a good, tough one. We haven't seen really a healthy Blake here for a full season. If we get him in the playoffs healthy, we're getting a win, if not two, no matter who we're playing, whether if it's Milwaukee or not. Go back to last year. It's been about a year now since we played Milwaukee in the playoffs. Game three, I was there. You guys know the drill. Blake was stopping Giannis. Giannis just didn't have a whole lot of stuff for him. And Blake was on one leg. You're telling me a healthy Blake, motivated to get his team a win, we don't pull one out? I'm not buying it. I'm not saying we won the series, but it at least goes five games. At least five games. That's neither here nor there, man. I hope Blake, you know, he's staying safe. You know, he's got a lot of properties. He's got a lot of workout equipment. He's probably got personal trainers there. So, I mean, he's getting all the bells and whistles. Just, you know, I hope he doesn't overdo it, you know, because I know being locked up and you want to get in basketball shape and you're trying to push recovery time, this is a perfect opportunity, man. There's no rush for him to come back, you know. Even if the season does come back, you know, we shouldn't play Blake. There's no point. You know, we're still trying to get LaMelo or whoever. In this case, we still can get Anthony Edwards if the lottery helps us out. You know, just whatever. There's really no point in playing him at all if the season does come back. If it doesn't, it works out well. He gets that much more time to rehab and work out and get ready for that year where we can make some noise. So I love to see Blake, man. He's been a great leader for this team since we've got him. You know, he's just, you know, it's a lot of money we're paying this guy. He doesn't play a whole lot. So, I mean, there's ups and downs with this, but I'm glad he's here. Hopefully we can do some serious work heading into the next year. Hopefully we get a favorable bounce in the lottery this year. Hopefully we go out there and get some good free agencies, signings, and, you know, hopefully it all clicks next year and we get to see some real progress with this team under Dwayne Casey and as the fans. But what do you guys have to say about this in the comments about Blake getting back to work? He hasn't stopped at all since, you know, he's been able to physically perform. I love to see this kind of stuff, man. This shows the dedication and love to the game, and I don't have any bad words to say towards that. But leave it down in the comments, Instagram, Twitter, DSA members in the description. All that said, I'll see you guys tomorrow. And that's the bottom line, because Detroit Drew said so. Peace.